It's the Kyle and Jackie O Show, the human calculator. Have you heard about this guy, Jackie?
I have.
He's the ambassador for the Commonwealth Bank's Australian Math Challenge. Details, everyone. I know you probably don't want him, but AustralianMathChallenge.com.
Now, this guy is as quick as a calculator.
Oh, he can't be.
He really is. He does it all in his head. And we're going to do a bit of a challenge, a bit of a game this morning.
We've got him on now. Scott, hi, buddy.
Good morning, guys. Thanks for having me on.
No worries. The world's fastest human calculator.
Yeah, but he might be good at maths, but is he good at anything else?
Yeah, he is actually. There's
like
another thing he's good. You're also the human calendar, which I can ask you any day and date and any year, and you'll know what day it falls on.
Yeah, what's he like in bed, though? Yeah,
fast.
I thought so.
Fast like everything else.
Yeah, exactly. Same reaction.
Well, okay. How have you become this human calculator?
The Guinness World Records got a hold of me a few years ago and actually had me race the fastest calculator in the world. And we both had to count by a number for 15 seconds. So the judge picked 38. The person on the calculator just punched in 38 plus 38 plus 38 over and over again as fast as she could for 15 seconds.
Yeah.
And I just had to keep adding it out loud as fast as I could. And I actually
beat it?
Yeah, they got 28 and I got 37.
God damn, how is that possible?
Let's try it just for fun. Kyle, pick like a tough two-digit number you want me to count by.
Okay, wait. I'll get my calculator.
This is starting to stress me. Are you getting the calculator out,
Jackie? I'll get the calculator.
Look, let's pick. What do you want to pick, Jackie?
Like, don't tell me till you pick it and you got it in the machine.
Okay, all right.
69.
And then plus 69.
Okay.
And hit equals. And I'm going to start counting by 69. And you just hit equals each time I say the next answer, okay?
Okay.
So you have 138. The next one is 207, 276, 345, 414, 483, 552, 621, 698.
Jackie, she's failed.
828, 897, 966, 1035, 1104, 1713, 1242, 1311, 138, 0144, 915, 18, 1587, 1656, 1725. Like that.
Far out.
I thought you were going to say something else then, Jackie, which I was exactly thinking the same thing.
Oh, my God. That's amazing.
Thank you. And it's just been a blessing. I get to travel around the world, and we host this World Maths Day. It's the biggest educational online challenge in the world, and we're looking for the best mathletes all around the world. So the Commonwealth Bank Australian Maths Challenge gives us a chance to find the best mathletes across Australia and celebrate them like you guys celebrate your athletes. And we're trying to make it to be cool in maths.
Well, you to celebrate our athletes until our appalling run at the Olympics.
Can I put? We're going to do a bit of a quiz, and we're going to see how you compare to us in the maths challenge. So,
I think I can know the answer before we do any challenge.
Well, here's the challenge, right, Scott? I'm going to ask you a series of maths questions, and I'm going to make them as hard as possible.
Really?
We'll see how quickly you get them.
Hey, can I just admit something before we go on?
Yeah.
Right.
I am so dumb when it comes to maths.
Me too, Kyle.
I don't even know my times tables, Jackie.
Me either, Kyle.
I know nothing.
Whoa. This is going to be fun.
Thank you for being honest on the air about this because it seems like it's become socially accepted to be bad in maths here in Australia.
And yeah, it is.
I can actually share with you right now the secret to numbers in less than 1 minute, and it will change the way you feel about numbers the rest of your life.
Really? Yep.
Well, yes.
Should you wait? Don't tell us until after the quiz because we.
Are you joking?
Yeah. Wait. Tell us at the end. Okay.
That's a great point. Thank you, Jack. That's a great point.
Right. Good one. Yeah. How dumb is she? Not just with maths, but with just normal brain power.
Here we go. Here we go. And then you will ask us a series of maths questions. You can make them. Well, please make them easy, and we'll see how long it takes you versus how long it takes us.
Okay. And what kind of problems are you going to give me? Are they addition, multiplication? What are we into?
They're all of the above. So it'll be your times table, division, and just simple adding.
Okay.
Here we go. 1,479 times 6,694.
9,900,426.
Oh, my God, that is 100% correct.
That's right.
That's tough stuff, guys. This is early in the morning. Come on.
Okay. All right, here we go. 452 divided by 52.
Well, that's an easy one, actually, because it's got to be 8.69.
Correct.
Wow.
Jeez, you're good. Okay. 345,000 plus 199,994.
Well, 544-994. That's easy addition. It's easy. That's
plus,
way best.
Plus 1,877.
That's tough. 546-871.
What happened, Jackie?
Did you say that? I punched in the right 544-994.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's
yeah,
right.
I was right. 546. Right.
I was, and
yeah.
I was using the calculator, and I was wrong.
I was nervous for a second. Thank you. Okay.
Okay. 67 times 4. I know I haven't finished yet, so just tell me when you want me to carry on.
Well, I'm ready. It's 268 so far.
67 times 4 plus 1 million minus 52,000.
Oh, my gosh. 948,
268.
Correct.
That is 100%
correct. Correct. Wow. Okay, tough stuff.
Okay, you hit us with that now.
I'm
Scott.
Thinking we don't have to prove much yeah. more that he's pretty good at it.
And all the kids at Chris Australia listening right now, this remember, they're not your role models for numbers and math here. They're just having fun with numbers. Today. So, all right, no pressure, guys. First okay. question is a simple multiplication. Let's do 5 times 7.
7, 5, that's 35.
Five. Yeah,
Kyle,
yeah,
1 to nothing. Jackie, let's go. Represent the girls, all right? Ready? Okay. Next one, simple division. We're doing 48 divided by 8.
I'm out.
6.
Yes, yes.
Well done, Jackie.
Okay, 1-1. Here okay. we go. We're doing subtraction. 100 minus 39.
39.
Kyle. 61.
Very good.
Oh, good one.
All right, one more, a okay. little tougher. Let's do an addition problem. Ready?
Yep.
781
yep.
plus 93.
874.
Brilliant. Yeah. Brilliant. We have a tie. We have a tie. Two. You guys want to end it that way, or you yep. want to have a tiebreaker?
Tiebreaker.
Oh,
go
God.
On.
Ready? And it seemed like division was the worst one for Kyle, so let's use that one.
Okay.
63 divided by 7.
9.
Oh, man. I ran right into that.
You know what? You know what? I only know my 7 times tables. I know none other. I only know the 7.
So you win.
Wow.
We're not so great, but you are, Scott. You're going to stick around because we have to find out next. He promised us in 1 minute he will explain to us what the secret is.
God.
I'm dying to find
Me
out.
Me too, because I am really bad at maths and have never been good at
I
it.
I want to be that good. So stick around. More with Scott next.
Kyle and Jackie O. Podcasting now.
It's the Kyle and Jackie O Show. Scott Flansburgh. He's the human calculator. He's the ambassador for the Commonwealth Bank Australian Math Challenge. He's on the air with us. He's going to tell us the secret
That's
of how
right.
you can be a math genius in 1 minute.
Now, Kyle, take a look at the calculator on your phone or on a calculator just so you can, you just need to see it to sort of process this. But everybody uses calculators all the time in our cell phones. They have 10 buttons on them.
Yep.
Take a look at those 10 digits on your phone. Is there a 10 anywhere?
Well, no. You have to make the 10.
Right. So it's not 1 through 10, but we teach our kids to count on their fingers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah.
But really, numbers are 0 through 9. And when you turn on a calculator, it always starts at 0.
Yeah.
And that's the only reason it works. And so you guys have to start at 0 down here in Australia. You're going to start thinking about numbers from 0. So now you have 10 fingers, and there are 10 digits, 0 through 9. And they'll fit on your fingers the same kind of way, but you end up at 9. And 9 is the biggest digit in the world, 0 through 9. So it's all about the number 9, Kyle, which you just said the answer to 63 divided by 7 was. So watch how simple this is. Every number in the universe higher than 9 adds down to 9. So write down the number 11.
Yep.
And now look at the digits. You wrote down a 1 and a 1. So add all those digits together. What's a 1 plus a 1?
2.
Put that total underneath the 11.
Yep.
And then subtract. What's 11 take away 2?
9.
Every number in the universe does that. So let's try 12. Write down 1, 2.
Yep.
Add it up. What's 1 plus 2?
3.
12 take away 3?
9.
Try 16. What's 1 plus 6?
7.
16 take away 7? Nine. Try 22. What's 2 and 2?
4.
Then you do 22 minus 4, and that will give you the answer of 18. But look at the answer, 18. What's 1 plus 8?
9.
So both of you and everybody listening, think of your age and write it down if you can. If you're driving, just try to do it in your head. Be careful. But write down your age, and now add the digits together and put that total underneath your age.
Yep.
And then subtract that smaller number from your age and look at your answer, and your answer should add up to 9.
Yep, it does. Yeah.
And that works for every number in the universe to infinity. And I'm on a mission to try to make every 9-year-old kid in Australia learn this so that when they're 9 years old, every number they see, whether they're watching footy or in the backseat driving down the road and they see a miles, kilometer per hour sign or whatever, it will give them an opportunity to exercise this muscle in their brain that's a calculator. So, Kyle, when you're driving home today, you're going to see a speed limit sign that says 50.
Yeah.
You just add it up. 5 and 0 is 5.
Yep.
50 take away 5.
Yep,
45.
It's 45. And 4 and 5 is 9.
9.
Everything comes to a 9 if you do that method.
And Australia has 9 letters, so it's going to be easy for kids to remember. And this will give kids a chance, if they practice this, when they go on the math challenge next week, it's next Tuesday and Wednesday, they'll have this confidence within them that will help them get through these answers faster and give them a chance to be the best mathlete in Australia.
Wow, that's amazing. Scott, I somehow feel like I'm not going to be as good as you, even though you've told me your secret.
Well, I got to see if Kyle can do one number on the air and make it go back to 9. Kyle, are you ready? Okay, so think of your... Come on, Kyle, do your age. How old are you? Like 62?
41. 40, 62. Okay, 41. 41. 41 is 5.
Yeah.
Yeah.
41 minus 5?
39.
Close.
What
41 minus 5.
Hang on.
Jackie, step in. Come on.
Is 36.
Beautiful. Yeah. 36.
Oh,
and that answer, 3 plus 6
is
9.
What's the point? What's the point of it?
Kyle, a beautiful question, Kyle. Brilliant, brilliant. Thank you for asking me.
Like, you can make everything 9, but why bother?
Thank you. I love that. So, Kyle, what's 1 plus 1?
2.
Prove it to me.
Oh, I'm out of here.
Come on.
No, how do you prove that?
How do you prove
other
that?
Other than grabbing like here's a pen and here's a pen, and you have 2 pens.
Yeah.
Other than that, there's no way to check 1 plus 1. You have to punch it in a calculator or ask your math teacher.
Yeah.
But we just teach our kids to memorize their math facts.
Oh, I see what you mean. People just know it.
So it's almost training your brain to do this subtraction. And is that right? It's exercising
now,
your brain.
If we want to check 1 plus 1, Jackie, start at the number 11. You think 1 plus 1 is 2.
Yeah.
What's 11 take away 2?
9.
If you get 9, everything's fine. It's a checker for the human brain, so you can do your math in your head. You don't need to check it with anybody else.
And when I'm looking at the sign that says 50, I don't have to figure out about 9. I just look at my speedo and go, I'm doing 50.
Oh, Kyle, stop being
That's right, Kyle. But the number 50 also serves a purpose for every mathlete out there. It teaches their brain 5 plus 0, because 5 plus 0 is 5. 50 minus 5 is 45. 4 plus 5 is 9. Everything's fine. Every number is an opportunity for you and kids out there to exercise this muscle in their brain that's a calculator.
Look, I would love to do it. I would love, but to me, it's too late. But for you listening at home, it's never too late. You should jump on the website because I would love to be able to do what he does. But for me, I'm too far
it's
gone.
It's never too late,
I'm too far
Scott?
Gone, Jackie. AustralianMathsChallenge.com is the website. You should do it because I wish I'd paid attention in school. I really do. I wish I didn't have violence in the home and I wasn't homeless as a child. And I wish I could do clever math tricks like that as well.
Well, Kyle, just for fun, at the end of the shows, what I do at schools is all the kids write down their birth date and I can calculate what day of the week that they were born on. So just for fun, you can use your birthday or any date.
Here, I'll give you one. December 20, 2007.
Thursday.
Yes. December 10, 2003.
Wednesday.
Oh, I must have got my anniversary wrong.
Yeah, you would have too. Yeah, he would be right.
You're right. It is. I just December 13.
Jackie. See, why try? You always do this.
I tried to outsmart him, and I looked like the fool.
You pick a genius in their field, and you try and challenge them, and I'm saying, don't even try. He's very good. Scott, thanks for coming on, the human calculator. Hey, guys, if you want to improve your maths, you should go and check it out. It's the ambassador for Commonwealth Bank Australian Maths Challenge. Details at their website, AustralianMathsChallenge.com. Thanks for coming on, Scotty. I appreciate it, buddy.
My honor. Thank you so much.